We're watching Scream 1996. I'm Adam.
I'm John.
And I'm Elijah.
Scream. I love this movie.
So do I. It's my second favorite horror movie behind Halloween.
Same for me.
Copycat?
No. And
I think I've seen it a long time ago.
He thinks he's seen it a long time ago. Hopefully he doesn't remember much, because that's what will probably be part of the fun. But if you do, it's okay, because it's still a good flick.
Long-standing Elijah tradition. He hasn't seen the movie we're doing a commentary track for.
Yeah. Or he's seen the movie, doesn't remember. And then I remember this.
I might start remembering it.
That's all right. Have you seen Scary Movie?
No.
Okay, good. Because a lot of people, unfortunately, get spoiled by Scream through Scary Movie, the spoof film.
I've never seen Scary Movie.
So. Yeah. Well, don't. It's not that great. In order to sync up with this commentary track, what you're going to want to do is pause when I say to pause, and you're going to want to press play on this commentary track as soon as the Dimension Films logo goes to black. As soon as that's away from the screen and you see black, you can press play on this commentary track. But for now, press pause. 1996 Scream, baby.
And that's the year I was born.
Is that a unique font?
It looks like that ad that's like, if don't steal a car.
Yeah, it is in the credits. At least. Hey, you know who that is?
You wouldn't download a car.
Very young Drew Barrymore.
Yeah. The voice is so great.
Who does the voice?
Roger L. Jackson. Some guy.
It sounds so like generic.
It sounds so like smooth and perfect. Yeah, I love it. Oh, so good. I love this movie.
I like her makeup, how it's like... Ooh.
Dissed.
Nice.
You said 96?
96. Mm-hmm. 2 years after I was born.
Wow. Establishing shot of a swing set.
I remember the first time I saw this, I watched Scream 1, 2, and 3 on VHS. Yeah. My sisters rented them from the library. We marathoned the 3 in one night.
Whoa. How old were you?
God, probably too young. Probably like 8.
I didn't watch this till I was like an adult. I didn't watch many horror movies when I was a kid. So, do you make popcorn?
I've never made that. They still sell it though.
Yeah,
I've seen that brand Jiffy Pop.
I wonder if it's better than microwave popcorn.
Yeah,
look what she does here.
What comes to mind? His voice is so perfect.
Yeah, I know, it's so like scary. There we go.
Oh yeah! Great choice.
Halloween. Is the guy who does the voice, is he in anything else?
I think he's just like a voiceover actor.
Oh.
Now this is funny. Wes Craven, the director of this, directed the first Nightmare on Elm Street, and he didn't want that line in the movie because he didn't direct the sequels. But then he did direct the 7th one, so he thought it was okay.
Okay.
Wait, he wrote this, and then he directed the 7th one. He's like, okay, well, the line works.
I would feel bad about that, too.
I said, God, that's so good.
Who I'm talking to. What did he said, say? I want to know who I'm looking at.
Ooh.
That's so good, the light in the porch. This is just going to be us being like, oh, it's so good.
I know. It's so good. Okay, who do you think the killer is?
There's just something about
Elijah's bit, ooh.
There's like an art to horror movies where it's like, if there's something good, you're like, oh, it's so good. Yeah. Like, you can really admire it.
They set this up so well. I love watching Elijah's reaction.
Slightly angry.
Charming, but
you keep angering a crazy person.
But... And the popcorn is going awesome on house. At the same time.
Oh, yeah.
Here we go. Listen, you little bitch. Oh, and you don't expect that.
Yeah.
He was so nice before.
More of a game, really. Can you handle that? Blondie.
Oranges. There were oranges. I wonder if that's like... Because ever since Godfather, that's
been
a thing.
Yeah.
No, like, it's like a legit thing. Like, oranges represent death.
this movie that made me never want to live
in the middle of nowhere.
This is the movie that made me never want to live like somewhere in the country. That, like, God.
Or carried a sawed off around with you at all times.
Yeah, Jesus.
Whenever I, and I'm not saying this as a joke, when did Columbine happen?
99.
Whenever I see this movie, it reminds me of like, whenever I see like Columbine or this, because I don't know, like the style of like the, what the kids wear and everything, yeah. Reminds me of Columbine.
Yeah, this movie, color ID went up like 300% or something after this movie. Because people didn't have caller ID at this point.
I wonder how many copycat crimes there were. Probably not many.
I thought you didn't have a boyfriend. She's so good in this. Wes Craven kept telling her about this like cat that died to make her cry because she's a big animal lover.
Oh, no. What's Drew Barrymore doing now?
She has a show. I will say, this movie, or this opening scene is the best part of the film. It's incredible.
Yeah.
This opening scene is so good.
Yeah, this is...
I mean, the rest of the movie is great, too, but this scene is incredible.
Yeah.
It's one of the best scenes in any horror movie, I think.
With this one?
Yeah. The opening scene of Scream is like a work of art of itself.
It's like a one-shot. It's okay, it's not a one-shot. It feels like a one-shot.
Elijah shook his head. So good. Yeah, she acts the hell out of this scene.
So, what was like Wes Craven? What was his goal with this? Like, he directed this movie. Mm-hmm. Did he write it?
No, Kevin Williamson, who was creator of Dawson's Creek and a bunch of other... He was a really big in the 90s. Mm-hmm. This is what got him on the map, though.
Oh. Was there any big inspiration for this movie? Mm.
He needed money. He's a big fan of Halloween, but... You know the answer, Elijah?
What's the answer?
You don't know you're gonna die.
Mike Myers. Wrong. Michael Myers. Mike Myers did Austin Powers. Ding, ding, ding.
Elijah, I'm just watching your face.
Elijah hasn't said a word.
What's the answer? Is it Jason?
That's the wrong answer.
This is great. Oh, such an asshole.
No way.
Afraid not.
Whoop. Wah.
That's true. Kevin Williamson said that's how he got a free drink at a bar. He stumped the bartender at that
question. Oh, really?
Yeah.
That's cool. It's Kevin Williamson.
Yeah.
Okay. I thought you said Williams.
John Williams.
This is gross.
Yep.
It's kind of over the top here, though, which I like.
Got him literally like a fish.
Man, imagine, like, if this really happened to you. It's like, that'd be fake.
Yeah, this scene terrified me when I was a kid.
Mm-hmm.
I was like, ugh.
What's her show called?
The Drew Barrymore Show. It's like a talk show.
Oh.
She did like a whole Scream section on it where she had a bunch of people from the franchise like call in and do stuff. And I was like, that's kind of cool. She did a thing where she wore that wig and looked the exact same.
Oh, man.
It's like, man, she hasn't aged a day.
Man, she's a good actress. She should be in, she should be in more stuff. She was in the Adam Sandler movie and then blended.
Yeah.
And the popcorn still like on going. Fire. That's so great. And now she's Michael Myers. do. The thing this movie doesn't have is like a score, like a music kind of sting. Yeah.
It does have good good soundtrack, though. I like the music in the movie, like that they use.
Do they use a bunch of like 90s pop?
No. Just like this music the, right the now and score. Stuff. They have like a lot of like,
haunting, good.
Like
it's serviceable.
Yeah. Yeah, this is one of those movies where like the screenplay is just so good. Like it's such a tight screenplay.
Yeah. Oh my god. It's stuff like that.
Yeah.
When the villain is shown in a voyeur-esque, like a candid way.
Voyeuristic way, yeah.
Yeah. That always gets me. It kind of humanizes him and it makes it scarier somehow. It's so scary. And the scream mask. That's so cool. Yeah. The way they made it for this film. It feels like it always exists.
Yeah.
So close. Ugh. Run. Why do you still have the phone in your hand?
This is a great shot. Yeah, it goes into slow-mo.
Yeah. Yeah, this is how you do slow-mo. I'm assuming that knife was kind of like...
collapsible.
Yeah, collapsible.
Probably, yeah.
Oh, shit.
Yeah. Oh god, this part's so sad.
Yeah.
This opening goes from like close. From funny to like scary to like really sad and depressing. Ugh.
And she can't
yell cuz he smashed her throat.
Throw the phone.
And the great shot of the where she pulls his mask off.
Mhm. Oh yeah, oh, yeah.
Pans she does up. That. So good.
It pans up. Elijah, don't say a word for the rest. This is gonna be your first. Whenever we need your input, we're just gonna put your face.
Yeah, I think the opening is an incredible piece of filmmaking. Yeah. I think it's so well done. That's all a one shot.
That does look really fake, though. The knife does.
Mm.
Looks wobbly. Oh, that's why she still has the phone, so we can have that in there.
I could do it. Hey! That's a line from Halloween.
Really?
Yeah. That's what they like. Go down to the McKenzie's.
And that's something you would never pick up on unless you're the big Halloween fan. Oh my god.
Oof.
She revved that screen.
And from the swing that they established in the opening shot.
It's like something out of Jeepers Creepers.
Yeah. That opening terrified.
All right.
So that's the opening.
What's your review?
Jesus, that's a lot. Heavy. Yeah.
Heavy?
Yeah.
No, like what?
That got horrible and really sad.
Yeah. So, this movie is marketed as though she was the star, Drew Barrymore. So that was a big shock to people when she died right at the beginning.
Was it really?
Yeah. She done E.T. as a kid and stuff, so.
Was it really like in the trailers marketed like she was?
People just assumed, and she was like the big face on the back of the poster, and she actually got this role, which is the lead, and she wanted to play the opening girl, Drew Barrymore's idea. She was like, it'd be great if I played the opening, because then people would expect me to be in the rest of the movie. It was like her idea. It's like, what a smart... She got the best scene in the movie. Genius.
Drew Barrymore, what the heck? You should be a filmmaker. You knew so much. But she's like...
Neve Campbell.
She's beautiful.
I think Neve Campbell's perfect in this. Yeah.
No, I'm saying like... Look
oh, yeah, yeah.
She's like the perfect.
She's the best.
Best looking.
I think woman. She's the best scream queen. She's probably the best horror movie final girl. She's so good.
Better than Jamie Lee Curtis.
I do like him in that.
Close call.
Not Johnny Depp.
Wait, so you think she's better than Jamie Lee?
I think so. She's really good. Jamie Lee's great too.
Yeah.
He looks like Johnny Depp. He looks just like him.
Dude, he does.
Mm-hmm. I love the aesthetic of this movie.
Mm-hmm. His hair, so 90s.
Yeah, like... the old 90s.
There's lots of film references in this, yeah. Which is one thing I love about it.
Lately, it feels like we're just edited for television.
Here's a test. Go ahead and say the whole dialogue to your girlfriend at home and see what her response is. The no-no zone.
No sex stuff in this. No nudity. Nothing. You don't ever see anything, just so you know. I won't need to cover your eyes at any point. Both of you. You're a little too young.
Yeah, fast.
You just hear the song. It's Don't Fear the Reaper, which is in Halloween, but it's a slow cover of it.
When is it in Halloween?
It plays when they're driving on the way to the house.
And no, there's no cowbell in this one.
Yeah, yeah.
La, 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 la. Don't fear the reaper. That's like the best SNL skit ever, right?
Yeah.
One of the best. No, the best one's the alien invasion. Have you seen the alien one with Kate McKinnon? That's yeah, the yeah. best one. That's so good. She wants it, though.
That guy's named Skeet Ulrich. Hell of a name.
In real life? Or?
Yeah, Skeet Ulrich. His character's name is Billy Loomis.
Why would you name your...
Yeah, Loomis. Loomis. A lot of references. Which in and of itself is a reference to Psycho. The name Loomis.
Uh-huh.
Sam Loomis, which they was
referencing. I love that. I love how we keep referencing, like... Yeah. I want filmmakers to keep doing that. Referencing mm-hmm. older stuff.
Yeah.
Who's that? You know.
Classic boyfriend climbing through the window trope. So you can do a horror movie without having to do nudity stuff.
Yeah,
you it's can. Fine. You can yeah. easily like, do it.
What did you say you want new movies to do more of, John?
I like how they keep referencing... older stuff like
that guy's name's Billy Loomis, which Dr. Loomis is the name of the doctor in Halloween, which is a reference to Psycho. There's a character named Sam Loomis in Psycho, so it's like the name is just carried
on. Well, that's just life, honestly. Yeah. I mean, if
I like keeping a legacy going.
We are impacted by things that we'll never know we were impacted by.
Yeah, exactly. You know
what I mean? Art forms and everything.
That's always been there. So that what happened last...
Like, how many people have been influenced by Shakespearean dialogue and never once read Shakespeare? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
How many artists themselves?
The color she's wearing is my least favorite color.
Highlight green.
I hate that color. I hate highlight green. Ooh, what's her name? Rose McGowan? McGowan. Even here, she looks like plastic. She looks like Michael Jackson.
She got in a car accident at some point and had to get, like, facial reconstructive surgery.
Now I feel bad. Thank you. I didn't know that, actually. We'll mute that. We'll cut that out. Yeah. Now, is she a redhead? In the light, she looked like red hair.
It's bad.
She said even worse than...
We'll get to that. Okay. It's just some setting something up,
mm-hmm.
which you'll find out soon about her. Sydney. What the girl's name in scary movies, like Cindy or something. Fonz. Barry Winkler. Barry Winkler. Henry Winkler. Barry Zuckerkorn from Arrested Development. He's very good.
No, what's his name in Arrested Development?
Barry Zuckerkorn. He's very good, but he's actually a terrible lawyer. That blonde girl, that's her brother, that guy, the mustache.
This is like her best friend's brother.
Yeah.
Who's that?
That guy?
Yeah.
Principal.
Are they related?
Nope.
Different time.
Is he the killer? What do you think?
Who's the killer? Is that lamppost?
Yeah.
No, it's a creepy looking lamppost.
Oh, dude, we're about to get into some of the stars of the movie.
A classic.
I will say, a person
there's a dog.
I absolutely love, an actor, Matthew Lillard.
He's a treasure, and we must protect him at all costs. He's incredible in this movie.
He's incredible in, like, Scooby-Doo.
He's Shaggy. That's Shaggy. He's so good in this
movie. Like, I don't know, man.
Yeah. He's like...
Also, he's Jamie Kennedy, probably the best character in the movie. He's the audience. Mm-hmm. I think it takes a man to do something like that.
Pretty easy. You're right, the music here, like a lot of piano.
That's a good line.
Yeah, for like 2 seconds.
That was funny. What does that mean, high school Q?
Status quo.
Oh.
Sliced and diced. Yeah. I usually don't like Jamie Kennedy, but he's great. And he's so good in Scream.
Which he, has he released a part two to his...
He hasn't, Son of the Mask video.
He's made
something like that.
Why they? I love how they talk. Like it's like everybody talk. It's like when you look at like a 20s, like a early in the 20th century when they're like talk like this. Yeah. It's like in the 90s they talk. They talk like surfer boys.
If I was any character in a movie, I'd probably be Randy from Scream. Like just a big movie buff.
I love that like challenge, like the Instagram challenge. Like what three fiction characters are you?
Yeah,
I could see you being Jamie Kennedy in this.
Lip. It was a joke. Liv, it was a joke. It was a joke.
Liberal.
I think he's incredible in this movie.
I think he's really good at a certain character.
Yeah. He's a really cool guy, too. Like, I've watched him in interviews, and he seems so down to earth.
Mm-hmm.
Like, he goes to those cons all the time, and he always, like, is very transparent about it. He's like, I really appreciate you guys, like, doing this transaction for us, because it helps actors that are... kind of down in luck right, like, or not getting a lot of jobs. He was like, and he makes it very transparent, like, this is a transaction, like, we're a fan, that's great, but you're paying me and I appreciate it. It's like, he seems like such a nice guy.
Like thanking people for paying him like small dollars.
Yeah, to like for like an autograph and stuff. He's like, it helps us out and helps us be able to keep doing what we love.
Hey,
to
as
do.
Long as you're
and
honest.
Like, yeah, that's most people are just like, oh, thank, like, you know, he's just like real genuine about it. So he seems like a really cool guy.
Tells it how it is, actually.
Yeah, yeah.
He takes away the facade of like, you're paying me for some sort of unknown reason,
right?
And in Jamie Kennedy's mask video, Son of the Mask, he says that he almost got the role in Without a Paddle.
And
he said
that Matthew Lillard.
Yeah, it went to Matthew Lillard.
Yeah, that one got Elijah. This is a fun movie to watch with you guys. I'm so happy to watch this.
The soundtrack is good.
It is.
That's what a beautiful that? House, too. Wes Craven's the man, dude.
Phone, maybe.
R.I.P. Wes Craven. He passed away a couple years ago. But
oh, he did?
Yeah. He directed all the Scream movies, 1, 2, 3, and 4. He's not going to do the new one, obviously. But so this is the important stuff they were talking about earlier. Just got to listen.
What'd you say?
Oh, highlight green. Yeah. Is Woodsboro a reference to Halloween?
Mm-mm. That's her mom.
Yeah.
That's what they're referencing.
Yes. Yeah. That's why she stopped and said, even worse than, it's bad. Like, she didn't want to
say
it. Are
they friends?
Yeah. They are. That's why she had to, like, she didn't mean to say it. Nice. Yeah, she was, like, stopping herself.
Does this take place in, like, a state?
California.
Like, California.
Beautiful houses in this movie. Yeah. Like, her house looks so cool.
Mm-hmm. See, and we're getting, like, really, like, sentimental stuff here. It's not, like, all horror.
Yeah.
Like, it's just sad.
They help you, like, care about the characters and stuff, too. That's, again, something about this first movie. She's... When characters die, you feel it and you care. Like.
Ooh, that's a beautiful shot.
Mm-hmm.
Ugh. Beautiful. It's like Lion King. Oh, Sonya!
Elijah's, like, toned.
You suck, John.
He's
such
a job. Does. Gotcha. Thought it was going to be the killer.
Gotcha.
Oh, God.
Is that true?
John would know. Is that true?
I don't know if that's true. Why would a girl say that?
So who that's cares her blonde about Tom
Cruise's penis?
Nobody cares about that.
Tom Cruise. That looks like a comfy couch.
Mm-hmm. God damn. Oh. You knew? You freak.
Did he do that before she?
Yeah. I think Neve Campbell's such a... she's such a natural actress. I'm surprised she's not in more things. No. I think she's really good.
She's definitely great in this.
Mm-hmm. She just seems like very natural.
Yeah.
Like.
But it also could be Wes Craven's good
could be.
Director.
Yeah.
Which one is Randy?
The guy said he worked at the video store.
When he got fired twice?
Yeah. Twice.
Right. See, they're making fun.
Yeah, see. Yep. They're in on the joke.
Wait, who's Randy?
The Jamie Kennedy.
Boom. Like, it's like some big reveal. Okay, well. God, you're right. She's the best scream queen.
She's so good.
Jamie Lee Curtis would be like, what?
Yeah. Don't get me wrong. I love Halloween, but I just think the Sydney's
better.
A stronger character.
Yeah, she's a better character. Which I've never seen Nightmare on Elm Street. Is there like a character
Nancy, worthy of that? Not as good as Screamer Sydney, but she's fine. She's only in the first one, and the other one Wes Craven directed, New Nightmare, which is about the actors in a Nightmare on Elm Street playing themselves. Freddy Krueger comes in the real world. It's actually a pretty good movie.
Mm-hmm. We already did Freddy versus Jason on this, so we might...
New Nightmare,
New Nightmare.
That's a good That's my favorite Nightmare movie.
Yeah.
I like it more than the original.
Oh my God. The way that voiced
in Ghostface's insult are always so.
Yeah.
Ah, God. Great shot right here.
Ugh. Oh my God, that was so good.
So good. The camera work in this movie is so good.
She's wearing Adidas. What are they called? Somos?
Yeah. Oh.
Bang. Oh my God. Concussed.
Yeah.
It's like a carving knife, too. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's like a hunting knife. Yeah. It's a knife you used to hunt with. Ugh. Yeah.
Right in the nuts.
Get him. Nope. Now she has to do the horror movie cliche.
Yeah.
Run up the stairs. When she just
yeah,
said she
ate yeah, it. You're right, yeah.
And this is good because they set it up earlier.
This music's really good. Yeah, you're right.
The
yeah,
thing with did. The door. Lots of good, clever little writing in yeah. this movie. They set that up earlier in the film, and yeah, it's good stuff.
If I only had a shot to make one kind of a movie, like it'd this. Probably be a horror movie.
Oh, yeah. I'd want to make a movie like this, which is a huge order because I think Scream's yeah. great. Look at that. It just 90s. Seems
like... oh, no.
Call through the internet.
What do you think, Elijah?
He did it.
Huh? The lighting there. Pretty good.
Mm.
Oh, shit. oh, yeah. Do you know any other good trivia for this?
Yeah, look at this.
Shoots her. Bang.
Dude, Arquette's so funny.
I know he's in the fourth. I think I have seen bits of the fourth one because of him. Is he in all of them?
You'll see. I don't want to spoil anything.
So we are doing all of the Scream
Maybe.
Movies.
We'll see. Depends how this goes.
Didn't do what?
Yeah. What's the hit? Sydney!
Sydney! Sydney!
Courtney Cox is in this. As you saw earlier, she's the news person. Mm-hmm. Her and David Arquette met on the set of this movie and got married later.
David Arquette's the...
Dewey.
Yeah. Dewey with Courtney Cox?
Mm-hmm. They were together. I mean, yeah. They're divorced now, but they were married
of course
for 10
they
years.
Are. Look at that butt chin. Rose McGowan. Yeah, I mean, it's just so weird because that mask is like a staple of Halloween mm-hmm. now. And like to know that it wasn't made till 1996, it's wild.
My name is it Jesus. So yeah, that's Courtney Cox. If, I don't know if you know she's a friend.
I'm
stuff.
Not an
yeah.
idiot.
Yeah, okay. I just didn't know if you'd seen her and stuff.
No.
What you thinking, Elijah?
Who's the killer?
Who's the killer? Out of all the characters you've
obviously,
seen,
it's Billy.
It's obviously Billy.
Who do you think, though?
Oh, this
is that Danny McBride?
No. Would be now, though. God, she's so mean. Talking about her dad. This movie's incredible at setting up every mm-hmm. character as a son. That's what the sequels are really good at, too. But they set up literally any... It could be anyone.
Mm-hmm. like Scooby-Doo.
it's true.
What is a cellular...
Telephone.
Telephone. Celltel. yeah, boy. Wanted to get a little PG-13 with her, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. imagine he's like, I was watching The Exorcist and it made me think I wanted to have sex with my girlfriend. That was a little bit edited for television. Yeah. Then we had a PG-13 relationship.
I love the way he says that. He acts like a character from like Psycho. Yeah.
Yeah.
I could see like how he says, he's really,
I didn't kill anybody. He's also very good in this. Again, none of these actors went on to do like, I mean, they were popular at the time, but they're not still doing stuff. They're all really good in this.
Yeah.
Which some of the later sequels.
It's weird how Jamie Kennedy was probably the biggest star out of this.
Yeah, he got a show, The Jamie Kennedy Experiment.
No, dude, he is the biggest star out of this. Like, he had the show and he had.
Yeah. I guess Courtney Cox is a bigger star, but that's not necessarily because of this, it's because of Friends.
Which Friends already started at this point.
Yeah, 94. Because she wanted to
make America great again.
Yeah, I know Courtney Cox like lobbied for this role because she said, I wanted to play a bitch. Like, I'd always gotten to play such a nice character on Friends. I wanted to show people, like, I could play a bitchy character.
Really?
She does it well. Like, she's really good as Gail. And I know they wanted Dewey for the role, the guy who plays Dewey. They wanted him to play Billy. And he said he thought he was too old. And he really liked Dewey, said, which was written as a hunky kind of guy. But he was like, I don't know, I just thought he seemed like an interesting character. He's like, and I knew I'd get to kiss Courtney Cox. And then he married her.
That is so interesting that, like, you would pass up on the bigger role.
Yeah. But so Dewey also is, like, a very...
That's twice in this film.
Mm-hmm.
There's, like...
Yeah.
That's great. That's what you want when you're making a film. Like, for actors to be involved and be like,
yeah,
I feel like I'm more like this character, and when it's a lesser character.
Yeah. Also, like, it's weird to think he would have played Billy, because I don't think he would have done good at that, but he's like, I see him just as Dewey.
Yeah.
Like, he plays him so well, and it's weird that he was written differently, like, more of a hunky type guy, but he's, like, more of a lovable goofball, like, the way he plays him.
Like, what was like, the vision of Billy? Was he a goof?
Like, no, I think he was just, like, I don't know why they would have wanted David Arquette for that role, because he doesn't seem right for it, which he probably realized, like, I'd be better for the role of Dewey. But, yeah.
Courtney, with your highlight colored bit. I feel like this isn't done the best.
So,
is
she's writing a book about her mom's murder.
Yeah. I feel like that isn't done the best. The whole...
Yeah.
The reporter's role and everything. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's not done badly. I understand it.
Yeah.
But it's not... done too well. Is she in like
Bam Sid Super Bitch? I think it's a scary movie, like, throws that and smacks her in the head. He's like, I'll get one for your head too. So stupid.
It's a weird angle.
Look at the bunnies. Like, how is she doing that? That's cool.
How is she doing that?
What
did she say?
The lighting.
She said, do you really think Billy did it?
Yes. Shit.
Hey, interesting. He didn't come out of his room until after the phone call.
Okay, shut up. Come on.
Who do you think the killer? that's what I mean, though. They do a great job of, like,
okay.
It could be anyone. I'm not, believe me, I will not spoil it.
Is it America?
Well, John's going to be like, I don't know. That's a huh?
Yeah, I promise there. I'm not going to spoil it for you, though, because I don't want to ruin anything.
Look at penis.
Idiots. It's just like, he just gets up and leaves. What do you think of this movie so far?
I'm liking it.
You're so good. Far okay. Awesome. John. Awesome. That's great to hear. Oh, this is important too.
Mm-hmm.
So she said that was the guy that killed her mom.
Raped and killed her.
Yeah.
Did all that bad stuff.
Corn checks.
Ouch. Stop hitting me.
Stop it. Getting it's a tennis. Horror cameo coming up here in a second.
Jeep. Oh my god. Police cars used to be like Jeeps?
Yeah.
Oh my god, that's
Jurassic crazy. Park. That is the girl from The Exorcist, Linda Blair.
It is Linda Blair, isn't
yeah.
it? They are just making all... They yeah, knew what they were doing.
Tons, man. Dude. Wes Craven almost, like, didn't do this movie.
Why?
He just said he thought he wanted to do something other than horror movies, and he said he went to some con where some, like, little kid, it was, like, 10, came up to him, and he's like, your movies are getting soft. You need to do, like, a kick-ass movie again. And he's like, that's what made me, like, go back and, like, look at the script and go, like, if the job's still open, I'll take it.
Like, God bless
that thank guy. That kid.
Mm-hmm. Kenny Powers?
Yeah.
Danny McBride? She did. Now she looks like Jennifer Aniston there.
She does.
A little bit. I'm going to be on it. Doesn't... Oh my god, it looks like Danny McBride. I'm sorry. But I have never seen like an episode of Friends.
Really?
Yeah. Never. I've seen like clips, and it's funny when I watch. Sitcoms can be funny.
Yeah,
I feel. But it's. I think. I feel like they've run their course.
Yeah, it's kind of a dated concept.
I don't like. I hate the. I hate laugh tracks.
Yeah.
Why are your pupils so small? I was thinking of Cotton from Dodgeball.
Yeah.
I don't know, Cotton. I wait.
She got all that right.
Yeah. Was Cotton Jason Bateman or was he the other guy?
I think it was the other guy.
Yeah.
I think Jason Bateman.
Yeah, when they're wearing diapers. I don't know how they can wear diapers during all of this. Cotton, I never could.
It's a bold move, Cotton. We'll see how it plays out or whatever he says.
He was, like, in love there. I like your shirt.
Matthew Lillard.
Oh, my God. Every time, it's, like, weird. Matthew Lillard has a presence.
He does.
Like, every time he's in a scene, I
steals the show.
He needs to be in more stuff. Ow. And that's crazy, because, mm-hmm. like, that's unique to the movie.
Yeah. So. Christmas.
One crazy take. I think it was. It might have been a meme. Oh, somebody's like, Matthew Lillard should have won an Oscar for this performance.
And I'm like, hell yeah,
he's great in this.
Yeah,
like maybe
choose the
know.
Scenery, but he's great.
Yeah.
Not to spoil anything, but there's a tiny remember? Part in Scream 2 where they'd make a movie about this, and they have this scene. It's Luke Wilson and like Tori Spelling playing the parts, and it's so bad. The movie's called Stab.
What?
It's a movie within the movie.
Well, okay, we're gonna watch the next one, so yeah. We'll see my reaction.
Yeah, then. It's.
I've okay. never seen any other. One.
I'm surprised you never watched the sequels.
Yeah. Elijah's not.
Not the right time, bro.
Season. Idiot! No, listen. What? Why don't you just have sex with me? What an idiot. I want to have sex with you. You got butchered. Why don't you just do it with me? I don't understand.
Threw me in jail. Ooh, that was ADR. Oh. Columbine shooters right there.
Shut up.
Shut up. That was like God. The same sound effect when the scream came up, the logo. Fair. Oh my God. I wonder how they did that.
You probably got like a vest underneath.
Maybe. Yeah.
Just dull.
And you mentioned Columbine, but an interesting fact, the third film got rewritten because of Columbine. And
the third one?
Yeah, because it came out in 2000, right after Columbine happened. And they had to rewrite the script, and also it has way less violence in the third movie. There's way less blood in it because of that. Mm-hmm. So, pretty interesting.
You see those old soap dispensers?
Yeah.
It's like echoey. What the fuck? Bubble butt. One bubble butt is a compliment in my mind. Yikes. That's a bitch move. I feel like really bad for her.
Yeah, yeah.
She has a bubble butt. Screw her.
Dated. Another thing that's interesting with this movie is they do the, they have the very good thing with like the cynical teens, like they're all making jokes about the fact these kids just died and like.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah.
It feels very much like today's ironic generation. Mm-hmm. Like.
No, it's because like how do you cope?
Right. Yeah.
With that, like it makes sense for like, especially nowadays. Like I didn't live with it. Like all the mass like shootings in schools. Yeah. Like, the only way you can cope at that age is with, like, humor.
You don't understand it, yeah. It's like...
Or, I guess that wasn't... It kind of was humor. Yes. But...
I'm glad you're liking this so far.
It's well made.
It is. It's Wes Craven's the man.
It's like a clock ticking.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Reminds me of the Psycho.
Oh, see, they make a point of the shoes. Oh, which if you notice later in the movie, every character is wearing the same shoes, just to throw you off more. But you never know if that was actually Ghostface or if it was a prankster.
Yeah, that could have been a prankster. Because they established that there are pranksters.
Yeah.
On this campus, even though it's a high school.
Look at these actors falling in love. I don't know if you heard me earlier. They got married, later on.
When they get divorced.
2009 or something. They were divorced, playing a married. Never mind.
Oh, That's cool.
11?
Oh, man. 11? Honestly, like, a lot of voices sound like that.
The voice face. On the phone. Yeah.
Like, this voice, yeah. You could kind of... Uh-huh. If you aren't, like, really paying attention,
yeah.
Like, you'd be like... Oh,
God! Great reaction.
Oh, wow.
Good line.
That's pretty.
That is a good line.
Is out.
Siesta.
Nice.
He's so pumped. What's on his neck? He's really, was he really wearing a necklace?
That cringy, funny line.
He's so good. He does a Fonz thing here.
He's crazy.
With his hair.
Oh, he does?
Yeah.
Show me.
You'll see it. We're also going to get a double Bill cameo here in a second. Right here, he does his Fonz. Not there. Right here.
Oh, my God. They reference everything.
You got to. You
know what happens.
Yeah.
I'm going to fill my drink up.
All right. It's got to be one of the most pleasant curses to have that people want you because, like, yeah. Like, you know. What I
mean? Apparently, he's one of the nicest guys in Hollywood.
I'd imagine. I mean, I don't think you could be on Happy Days and not be a decent person.
He seems like a great. Oh, this is cameo. Hopefully. Look. That's Wes Craven, and he's wearing the Freddy Krueger sweater because he created A Nightmare on Elm Street. It's the original sweater from the first movie.
Seriously?
Too. Yeah.
Dude.
Said he pulled it out of storage.
That's almost too much of a reference.
Yeah. And his name was Fred. I don't know if you heard of him. He said, sorry, Fred, not you.
That's so funny.
What'd you call me?
Yeah.
Mr. Himbry.
Mm-hmm. This old panel, wood panel walls.
You missed the Wes Craven cameo as the janitor, and he's wearing a Freddy Krueger sweater, and his name was Fred.
I didn't know that.
He keeps scaring himself in the
I didn't know that he was a cameo in this.
What'd you call me?
I'm questioning, like, everything. Is Himbry
a reference?
Reference anywhere? Okay, the fact they do this is ballsy.
There's a really cool shot right here. Not this.
Right, like, you here. Kill... You
oh,
kill
I love the... it! That's so cool.
Yeah. Oh, that's so good. You kill the principal?
Yeah, pretty good.
In this song, it feels like, okay, school's out, like it's summertime, but it's not.
Well, it's a great transition to use after you kill the principal. You school's out.
Yeah, that too.
Great.
That's a great song choice.
Yeah.
Gail Weathers.
Good shot.
Mm-hmm.
When did she have that accident? The car accident?
Who? Oh, well, this was after this.
It was after this. Yeah, so yeah. I can't make fun of how she looks. I'm kidding. But she does look like Michael Jackson. Cotton Weir.
It's a weird name.
I love making names, like fictional names.
Wes Carpenter. That's what she said. She was like, starting to sound like a Wes Carpenter flick.
Oh my God.
There's one thing in this movie I don't like.
That? That?
This. Why would the killer be running around in broad daylight following them in the costume? Stupid. I don't like that.
Is that the only shot?
There's one more like that later.
Okay. Is this a movie store?
Yeah, video store.
Dude.
That's where it works. I love this.
Awesome.
Oh, look, Matthew Lillard's
Yeah.
Dude, $3 for one day.
Great.
It's a bad sign that, like, at our times, it's less than that.
No, yeah.
30 years later.
We had a family video near us, which was the best, and it was $1 for 5 nights.
Okay.
He's a smart guy.
Like, no way it was written like that. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, that's something you can't get when writing. Yeah. That's.
He's like that person. Look. Just look the back, yeah.
Is anybody listening to this?
She lost her target audience.
Brie Larson, you just want
to know.
God, he looks so young here. He looks like a cartoon character when he does that, like a Looney Tunes.
No, I don't at all. He is like a cartoon.
What's he doing there? Oh my God.
Oh, so good. God, the writing of this movie is so good.
The Millennium.
Great cuts, man. Great
this song is in the first all three for three first movies.
It's in all three of the
screen. Yeah, yeah. So a funny thing too, Matthew Lillard auditioned for the role of Billy, but they said he in his words, he was like, I was clearly not handsome enough to play Neve Campbell's boyfriend.
Yeah.
And then he later dated her in real life.
Oh, he did?
Yeah, for him, which is funny.
Good for him.
It's like it was quickly determined I was not nearly handsome enough to play the part.
I mean, he's brilliant.
Yeah, he's so good. As
he's perfect for his
role. Okay, really?
If I ever make a movie, I want him.
Yeah,
Because you can tell he wants to do
good.
I don't know. He wants to go all out. I shudder to think.
Wait, is he the endorphin rush?
Yeah, I guess.
So she's into him?
Yeah.
They're at an Aldi's right now, you know, just... So, is there a recent horror movie that kind of you can...
That's stupid. Why'd he be in the store?
Yeah, it is stupid.
In the costume?
Is that the last one?
Yes. Those are the only two things this movie I don't like.
Is there a recent horror movie that you would compare kind of favorites?
As good as Scream?
Yeah, kind of. I don't know. In a similar light?
Probably not.
No. Because they're all... I don't like... Demon. I don't like demon stuff.
I thought the Happy Death Day movies were like pretty fun, similar to Scream. They're not nearly as good as Scream. Not even close. This every time that guy smokes, he licks his ice cream.
Yeah. Not there.
He blew out his smoke.
Oh. Oh, okay. But see? Yeah.
Just like mirroring him.
What's he, what was it, like purple flavor?
It looks like strawberry,
grape?
I think.
Was he going to throw it down?
In Scary Movie, that's what he does. He stops his ice cream and stops it.
See, that is like what parody movies should be.
Yeah.
It's you are paying attention to that stuff.
To the details, like, and just make a stupid like gag on it, yeah.
Like, I didn't notice that. I wouldn't notice it
if
you didn't
tell
me.
That was a wacky shot. How did they do that? What was that? Did you see it? It like turned all around. I've never noticed that.
I love old Jeeps, man.
Oh, here's the killer. Throwing out the
potato chips.
Sour cream and onion?
Can't tell. Just reduced fat. I can tell it says that.
I think it says peppered pie.
Oh, I love this song. Who sings this?
Dude, the amount of lights you need to light up all those trees.
Oh, God, yeah.
Or just giant lights, I guess. I don't know. What happened to,
Oh, my God.
That is an enormous house.
This house is
beautiful
gorgeous.
House. This is a real house. Yeah. I know that, they recently did a screening of Scream here where you could, like, watch the movie at the house. They'd, like,
in, like,
out
that
in
little tiny TV.
I think they camped it out in the front yard.
That'd be great.
They had it on a big projector. That'd be cool to watch. And somebody, like, did a tour of the kitchen. It looks the exact
same. Oh, yeah.
Scene.
That'd be awesome.
Super cool.
I love that kitchen. Man, the 90s are so good.
Yeah. Take me back.
Mm-hmm. Let's just go hang out at a party, okay?
Yeah. I think the screenplay for this movie is really great.
No, we're incognito.
I don't know. I think it's a combination because, like, you have, like,
a good director,
Matthew Lillard doing his thing.
Yeah. They have great explanations for why every character is where they are and what they're doing. And,
yeah.
Like, she wants to be there to try to figure out what's going on with the story. And
let's go on a date at a high school party.
At a where?
A high school party.
Yeah, true.
Oh, jeez.
Oh yeah.
Man, he's like an idiot, but the camera dude's like simping hard for for her, right? Or he's just heartless, just like her.
Scream. Wait, what were all the movies she said?
Prom Night, Terror Train, and Halloween. She's in all those.
I haven't seen the other two. Prom Night, is Prom Night good? The original one?
Yeah, the remake's awful, but the original's good.
What was the other one?
Terror Train. Just like Halloween on a train.
Oh.
Yeah.
But that is like... I don't know. I guess different times, I guess.
Yeah. She's
We're dating.
She's just a news lady, right?
Yeah.
Ask her.
It's you, Adam.
What?
I need a camera.
I need a camera. I tell you, if I was any character in a movie, it would be Jamie Kennedy's character in Scream. Yeah,
I agree.
That's the one I want, Halloween.
You would never hear that nowadays.
Yeah.
In my kitchen.
Like,
I've never been to a party where everybody just wants to watch a bunch of movies. I would love it, but it never happens with my group of friends.
No, let alone...
They're like, let's play a game. I'm like, let's watch a movie. Shut up. Shut up.
Yeah, let's talk about it. But, like, let alone, like, Halloween, like, I feel like people don't
An
like
older film. Yeah.
Yeah, it's an older... Which, okay, I'm gonna say it. I'm gonna come out. It's like coming out of the closet.
I'm glad.
Real quick before this happens. I have had a new, like, perspective on remakes. I'm like, people, like, West Side Story's coming out. It's like, nobody's nowadays is going to go and watch West Side Story, the old one.
Yeah.
You have to remake it so people get the story out. So it's like, all of a sudden, I understand remakes. It's like,
I get it. Yeah.
We have to get the story to the youth. But, like, Lion King and Beauty and the Beast, it's like, no, that's too recent. But that was my short little take.
There you go.
Let's go on with the movie. I've been harsh on remakes. So.
Well, that's the thing I like about this is, like, obviously this movie is a satirization of, like, horror films.
Yeah.
It's a satire. The sequel is, like, a satire on sequels. Mm-hmm. And the third one is, like, satire on trilogies. And the fourth one is, like, a satire on reboots.
Yeah.
So it's, like, I do like that each film has its, like, place in filmmaking genre, which is cool.
Yeah.
How sparkly that room
I will
is.
Say she looks like a classic movie star, kind of.
She does.
Like, how she looks here.
So many horror movie references.
Psycho killer. Mama.
They always think it's real. Ugh. Easy way to do that effect, you just put the blood on the knife and just rub it on the mattress.
Nice. Now you stab him. It's locked. Whatever.
That wouldn't work
unless it was sugar glass.
Ghostface Killer is always so clumsy.
Yeah, they are.
This actress found out while she did this. She's like, I actually could fit through the garage door.
She said that.
She could. Oh. Whoa. Elijah's face.
It's a strong motor.
Kicking and screaming. I feel like this isn't possible, really.
Hey, I don't know. I guess if you're light enough, she's probably not that heavy.
Ah! What the? Okay, so what killed her?
It's like smashed her head. Like the went up and then her head crushed.
What her head crush on?
The edge of the garage door. Like the awning out part and it squished her head.
Her shoulder would have hit it, not her head. Yeah. Yeah, it's this. Yeah. He's so good. God. If... To be a director and to like have somebody like an actor like that into it. Like
so good.
Yeah. So there's a 30-second delay.
The headboard.
Yeah.
That's pretty Jeez. Cool. Okay. That's fine.
No, you haven't. Your mom died. Give yourself some break. It was a year ago.
Any other facts you want to throw at us?
You hear the music?
I know a lot about this movie. That's sad.
Has he been in anything?
He's on Riverdale right now. He's like one of the dads on
he's,
the show.
Oh my yeah. god, he's a dad?
Yeah, well, he's old now.
I know. What's Neve Campbell in?
What'd you say?
Like the bad seed. Yeah, what's no, bad seed?
It's like the Omen, about an evil little kid.
Another movie reference.
Yep.
Does she? I can't remember.
What you?
Excuse me.
One big movie.
We're all the actors. We're all the players.
Yeah.
Good one, John. You got it. You nailed
oh,
it.
Oh, thank you. Elijah said some.
Who you think the killer is?
Yeah, no.
Do you have any guesses?
Who's the killer? Can we get it? We need a guess. Fun
game. I don't know if I kind of remember or if I
okay.
Just
don't say
mixing it.
Well, no, I want you. What do you think?
I don't know. I just
no.
Watch.
Well,
seems like you don't remember
if,
much.
If you have you to say somebody's stuff? The killer, who is that somebody?
It, I mean, it could be him.
Okay.
Who do you think mostly? It, like,
well, it's not just that. It's I might be.
If you had to place a bet,
you might be mixing what.
Mixing up memories or something because I think I have seen this before, but it was a long time ago, and I was maybe it was in pieces or on TV.
Have you remembered like, bits of this so far as it's happened?
I've recognized the image. Okay. Yeah,
but who do you think is the killer?
I don't know yet.
If you had to choose, because we're
well,
about
he
to
said
reveal
he thought maybe him
eventually.
It's possibly him. I don't
we'll
know.
See.
You're we'll gonna see. Say him?
Okay, sure, John.
Okay. I want for
trying to watch
the
movie
for the audience. I'm trying to give the audience something.
They're watching the movie.
They're about
too,
to have sex. Oh. They don't see anything. It's done tastefully. We missed that little piece of dialogue.
Yeah, I did.
Yeah, she said. He said, "You can't pick your genre." She's like, "I'd love to be in something, maybe a porno." And he was like, "Are you sure?" And she was like, "Yeah." And they started kissing. That's fine. There, watch it. Which is hilarious. He says that because there's no blood in this scene in Halloween. Not at all.
Yeah.
Halloween is known for having, like, very little blood.
Yeah. As comparatively yeah. to...
See, I've never been in a place where everybody's watching a movie
that
like this.
That would be so amazing.
I love
though.
It.
I'd love to be in a place where...
Yeah.
But it's a movie theater.
Yeah.
Which is why I love movie theaters. Yeah. And why, like, I don't know, a lot of people don't like... I love movie theaters because you're on a yeah. place watching a movie.
Yeah. It's true. I love it. It's true.
Amen.
All the people who have sex in the horror movies die.
Who had sex?
Big no.
Who's having sex right now?
Cheers.
Yeah. Because he won't be back.
He's so good. Cheetos.
hard.
It's funny. It's the writer wrote that line too.
He's so goofy and lovable.
Hate Cheetos.
What'd you say?
I hate Cheetos.
Really? I'm not a big fan. I don't really like chips and stuff, though, either.
Wait, you don't like Cheetos?
I don't like cheese.
I have jalapeno.
Really? You don't like cheese?
For the most part.
I love cheese. Oh,
dairy is, yeah, I like cheese a lot.
I've never been Cheetos so apart cheese. From it's, you yeah, as yeah. I am right now. Adam, you're lucky. You're lucky Adam's in between us right now, okay? I'm kidding. I love Cheetos and cheese.
It's an enormous house.
This sounds like Halloween.
Yeah.
You hear that?
So this is well done too, though, because you can see she feels she doesn't want to do this really at first, like because of then she's like forcing herself to like no, like it's good character thing because she was like didn't just like want to go for it the first time. She's still hesitant.
Mm-hmm.
Again, you don't see anything.
Okay,
I promise. See, that's great. They're doing like the sex scene with,
yeah.
with an actual sex scene happening, which is great. I think this is the only one where there is a sex scene. I don't think there are any in the sequels.
And okay, this is one thing I don't like about the movie. I don't like how they use
the audio from Halloween.
Yeah, Halloween with their movie.
I like it. God.
They probably already did, but
that's another thing. The principal dying was added in the rewrites, Clerks. The principal dying was added in the rewrites because they I think it was the studio was like, you need to have like a death in the middle of the movie. You don't have anybody die from the opening to like the end of the film. Yeah. It's like, so you need to add more
that,
death,
yeah,
death
that
scene.
Is...
So they added that in and they gave a reason for the characters to leave the party. So it just worked out.
I liked my principal, to be honest.
Yeah.
If I found out my principal, my school died,
be
I'd be
like whoa, let's
I'd be
go
like,
check it out.
Oh my god. I'd be like sad. Oh.
Look at those lens flares. See them? The blue.
No.
They were in the trees. You'll probably see another one in a minute.
It does, because weather. Weather is...
Gale.
Gale. Oh, my God. Oh, that's good. That's a good shot, because...
Let's just casually kill some people on our way to the football field.
They're all drunk.
Oh my god, she looks into it. Oh my god.
She is.
Bad response. It's a bat signal.
Bum, my whole bum, life.
Okay, I'm confused. I don't remember that part. Oh, I remember. I remember.
I remember.
So they had sex, right? Probably. Whatever. Mm-hmm.
Yes, they did.
Inkle's dead too. And another thing, why would you call your Coke?
This seems really well done too. So.
Oh my god.
This is really well done, this whole scene. What she sets up, what he says. And then. Ah. See, that scene's brilliant because they set it up that it could be him, and they make you think for, like, you think at first it's not him. Yeah. Or it is him, definitely. Then it's like, oh, it's probably not him. Then there you're like, oh, it could be him. And then you find out there, no, it's not him. So good.
Get out of here. God,
he hasn't.
Oh, he got there somehow. The wood really is a good aesthetic. Ooh.
Yep.
A surf.
Smart.
I guess, yeah.
It worked.
I just want to say Scream is a great name for a horror movie.
You know what the original title for this movie was?
What was it?
Scary Movie. And then they changed it because I think Bob Weinstein was like, that stupid title. You got to change it. They called it Scream, and they were all like, what a bad idea. What a stupid
That's
name.
That's the better movie. Weinstein.
Yep. And then they obviously ended up using Scary Movie for the spoof film.
So you have trivia up in there.
Yeah, I know. I know some stuff.
Oh, that was lucky.
Yeah.
That still would have hurt.
Hell
really
yeah. Oh, that was lucky.
That was a big fall, too.
Yeah.
Oh, it never existed. We live in a perfect world of utopian.
Ugh.
Oh, my God. That looks so bad.
How did nobody notice that?
To the back of the house, I guess.
That's probably weird for him.
This is brilliant because the actor's name's Jamie Kennedy.
Yeah.
So another little bit of meta.
I never noticed
that.
So
good. That's so clever.
Behind Jeremy. You've seen Halloween, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. We've seen Halloween Resurrection. Not Resurrection. What was it? Was it Resurrection?
Yes, yeah, we watched that.
On the channel, so check that out. It's the link in the info below.
Oh, this is also brilliant.
Ooh.
Again, bit of good screenwriting. Because this was set up.
Yep. That's why I said 30 seconds.
Yep.
Oh, ah, no.
That 30-second delay is
so
good.
That's so good. Yep. He's like, whoa, I killed him. God, I really love the sequence here.
Mm-hmm. God, ow.
Mm-hmm. I guess so. Maybe it's in my head. Like, I've imagined being trapped in a car before and that happening and getting out. That made me think about it.
You shouldn't watch The Raid or The Raid 2, I think. It's a movie where a guy gets stuck in a car and, like, 20 different guys with knives punch through the windows. and starts stabbing him.
Be careful.
This is the thing you said you didn't like. I like this. Even though continuity-wise, like, for what that what's like happened, it, Halloween it, should not this, be this at this
looks
point.
Like, this looks like Clue.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't like how it uses, it kind of, I don't know, uses another person's product.
Mm. Ah, but they transform it. Oh. At it for comedy when he's jumping around.
Kind of like what we do, right? Yeah, Jester there you go. With their reactions. The what?
Cellular.
What's a cellular?
Where is he?
Get it, powers! Cheetos.
Cheetos aren't red.
Cheetos on my shoe. Your shoes are orange.
What's going on?
Three.
Was that Jamie Kennedy?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I was like, what's going on?
Bop, bop.
Good windshield wipers.
Yeah.
God.
Oh my God. Hit her. Maybe she's the killer.
They're all the killer.
Yeah.
Elijah.
He doesn't.
Fatality. No. Ouch.
I like the fact that I know who the killer is, and Elijah doesn't know.
What? As soon as the reveal happens, Elijah will be like, oh yeah, I knew that.
Yeah, he's going to react. What? That's the killer? I'm gonna be like, yeah.
Wait, there is one other thing I remember just now. I remember there that I don't like in the movie. I'll get to it.
Let us know when it happens. Oh, that? Oh, shit. Dun, 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 dun. Who do you think the killer is? Elijah. Shut last up. Chance.
Jump. Elijah, jump.
Billy?
Shut up, John.
Okay.
I think it's Sid.
I think this is the scene I
that
was thinking.
That freaked you out?
Yeah. I'm like, if I was in a car, like, with this situation, I was like,
and then,
yeah.
That Wes Craven man, he knows how to do tension. There's a scene in the second one that is, like, one of those scenes that when I first watched it, I was like,
like, no, consistently, no, like, I don't.
No. Yeah. I was like,
In the second, I haven't seen. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I'm excited to do the sequels. Good camera.
I love that camera.
It was like tilted. And
go. Yeah.
What do you do?
Oh my gosh, who's the killer?
She makes the right choice.
Yep, yep.
That's
yep.
The best thing
amen,
to do.
Amen, sister.
Right, here's the other thing I coming up that I said I didn't like. I mean, I can forgive it, but.
I'm wondering what it is.
Yeah, this plot armor. No way he'd live. But whatever.
No.
Yeah. Not a big fan of that. He should be dead, but.
But no, he didn't. They didn't. No, wait, hold on a sec. Well, I'll fight you.
He should be dead.
No, wait, yes. No. No, listen, you'll see.
It's unrealistic, but whatever, watch. No, just watch. Listen. Just wait.
Shush.
Plot armor.
You're just arguing and covering up the movie.
No.
Yes. Ah.
No, listen. Is that a psycho reference?
Yes.
Yeah.
He says that.
Shit. Ah, well, hold on. Wait. Oh, there you go. Yeah.
I was trying to keep up the illusion.
Oh, yeah. So you were faking it?
Yes.
Okay.
Do you remember that?
I kind of do. Yeah.
Dang it. There are two.
There are two That's a killers. Great twist.
That's a great twist, though.
Yeah.
To have two killers. Because the first time I saw it, that blew my mind. I never expected that. Yeah. I was like, oh, two of them?
And that makes everything so much easier. Uh-huh. Like,
the movie from here gets, like, insane.
Yeah.
Oh, this is where Matthew Lillard really shines.
Yeah. Oh, he's so great here.
Yeah,
you die.
You die.
They're like little twins.
Yeah.
Who's Cotton?
The guy that she said killed her mom.
Oh,
they're basically
just
admitting they killed her mom.
What? Yeah, it's a good question to ask.
He's good in this also.
Yeah.
They play it differently. He's more in control and the other one's more unhinged.
Yeah, yeah. It's so interesting. It's like, how did they meet up? Like, it's like, let's kill somebody.
Maybe you find out
it's like Columbine, kind of. Like, that's why. That's why it reminds me of Columbine.
The big trick I don't want to
do. Oh no. I didn't remember this.
So he has a motive. The other one doesn't really.
Yeah. He's just kind of psycho.
Yeah.
Cartoon character.
Yeah,
Looney Tunes. Those are the rules.
Yeah, they're psychos. They're crazy.
So you really. Okay, so you were faking the whole thing?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
I was trying to fake it for Elijah's sake. So, at what point did you remember that there might have been two?
Before John started gloating.
What? When did I start gloating?
Elijah, tell me. Tell me who it is. Tell me who it is. Tell me who it is.
Do you remember anything else from here on out?
I don't think so.
Okay,
so
okay. I won't say anything.
Oh no.
Baby.
All right there, baby.
Here's this is where it gets fucking insane.
Yeah. I love this part.
I'm ready, baby. God.
This is where Matthew Lillard's like, oh my God. Because he actually got stabbed here.
Yeah. God. There's always one thing, though, that I had an issue with this that I always said wouldn't have made sense in their plan. Billy has all that fake blood on him. How's he going to explain that to the cops?
Yeah, you're right. Yeah, like there's a bunch of corn syrup. Yeah. Like what?
God. They're just butchering each other.
Yeah. I got you a little too zealous.
God, it's just insanity. It's just two crazy people cutting each other up.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Ugh. That's probably the most memorable part of this
Everybody
movie, I think.
Everybody dies but us. We get to carry on and plan the sequel.
And you can tell that's what Billy told him.
Yeah.
And he's just like a follower.
Yeah. This is a line that...
Movies make psychos more creative.
The MPAA did not want that line in the movie. They were like, no.
What?
Gotta cut that. The MPAA didn't want that line in the movie.
But they didn't cut it.
No. Well, they fought for it. Oh. Like, but they were like, you can't have that in the movie.
Yeah.
Like, that's going to make people do crazy
stuff. Yeah. Be more creative.
Ugh. I'm feeling worse here.
No, yeah, we haven't gotten that. But did you hear it say? Oh, that's like my favorite line. Yeah.
Get a little woozy here. Feel a little woozy here.
A problem here.
What?
I have to go to the bathroom.
God, right, man. You got a cord on. Yeah. Geez, you're freaking 22. You said in the cheek for sure first comment. Yeah, man. Yuck. Idiots. Oh, I love this. That really hurt me too deep. I think I'm dying here, man. God.
That's Matthew Lillard here is like one of my favorite parts.
There's an improv part coming up here in a minute.
I'm feeling a little woozy here.
Hello?
I think I'm dying here. Is that the peer pressure?
No. Here comes this.
I mean, is that the
ad-lib? Here it is. This was improv. You fucking hit me with the phone, dick! He's like drooling. Looks like a chicken.
Yeah.
Why the hell are you dressed like a chicken?
What's that from?
What'd you say?
What's that from?
Home Alone.
Oh.
I don't think she's in the couch, buddy. Why'd he cut the couch up?
Yeah, why would she be? You're right, yeah, why would she be in the couch? Yeah, and they have that.
So right here, no. Where he screams a second, right? He has, like, apparently he had a pad underneath, but she missed, and he has this, like, he had a heart surgery as a kid.
Yeah.
He has this little metal thing that's sensitive, and she hit him right on it. So when he went, ah, that was real. He, like, really screamed.
Oh, no, I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's awesome. Like, she's like, I'm going to be...
Yeah.
The victor.
No, that she's a little crazy too.
Yeah, Sydney's a badass.
Yeah, yeah, she is.
She's
a badass.
So cool. I think this part was improv too. They came up with it.
Well, the TV.
I always had a thing for your Sid in your dreams. Yeah. They came up with that. God.
What a death there.
Yeah.
Aw, no. What a great movie, huh, fellas?
Yeah, I love it.
We're having a great time. This is Just Chatted Productions here.
Yeah, he lives. My favorite character.
Oh, my gosh.
I never thought I'd be so happy to be a virgin. Oh. This part's gross.
Oh, no.
Just...
Oh, yes. right in the womb. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. The way she...
Yes, queen.
She's like, you stick me, I stick you.
What'd you say? Yeah,
nothing. What'd you say? I'm gonna go make the Jamie Kennedy experience. The star and saw the mask. See you. Wait. This is. I'm kind of.
Nah,
I don't like this that much, but. It's okay. It's okay. I get it.
Dead.
I get it.
Hell yeah. Get him.
The fire.
Did she just forget about her dad?
No, she threw him in there. She picked him up and put him in there.
And then, well, put on a costume.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
No, but it's weird because he opened it up.
He was somehow he was further back in there.
I guess, yeah.
Because a bunch of stuff fell out with him.
Yeah.
Hey, look. He lives. Also added at the last minute, because originally in the script he died, and they said, like, do a take where you just move around. And then when he saw the premiere, he's like, oh, I lived. Cool. Like, he didn't know. Look at that house.
It's a good house.
There'd be more trees around it.
What'd you say?
I thought there'd be more trees around it.
Yeah. The original title.
That would work. The title was Scary Movie. Mm-hmm. Screams.
You hear what she said after that? It all began with a scream that started, and then an 911 call.
Yep.
Yeah, exactly.
Got a new cameraman pretty quick.
Ah, that's the end.
What'd
you do that?
Just scare you guys.
Drink bite, Wes Craven. Written by Kevin Williamson.
This is that font you were talking about.
You wouldn't
about.
Download a car.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, that was fun.
And you wouldn't download a movie.
Oh, yeah.
Wait.
You would download
Harvey Weinstein.
You don't want the Weinstein stuff.
Get them out of your butt. Oh, what a fun movie. Well.
That was great of time.
What'd you think?
It's good.
Yeah, did you like it?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
What was your favorite
Would you be
parts?
Interested in seeing the sequels?
Probably.
Probably.
Yeah.
Sure, why not?
Why not?
Yeah, maybe. They're not as good as the first, but First is definitely the best one, but yeah. Two's not bad. Three is eh. I don't really like four, but a lot of people like it a lot more than three, so.
Mm.
But yeah, I think it's a great flick.
Super My fun. Favorite horror movie outside of Halloween, just because I like how honest it is and how, like, mm-hmm. I don't know, it's like it captures like the 90s.
Yes, as well. I agree with that. I think it's also just fun.
It's like a coming of age film almost.
Yeah, like a John Hughes type movie. That's a horror film. Yeah, it's fun. The characters are cool.
How do you say her name? Nev.
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 Yeah, Nev.
That's very unique.
Uh huh.
Courtney, you say Courtney Cox.
Matthew Lillard.
I feel like I pissed off Elisha today. That's all I've been doing.
Rose McGowan. As you said, Michael Jackson. Skeet Ulrich. Skeet, see what a name.
I think it's Ick.
Skeet is an unfortunate Skeet. Name.
Ulrich.
Jamie Kennedy. Look at those teeth.
Yeah. That's a great first name. Yep.
Lee Schreiber.
Yep. I was going to say. He's
you know him.
What's
Andrew Barrymore.
Ray Donovan.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wait, who?
What do you know Lee Schreiber from?
A Sabretooth.
Oh, that's funny.
Yeah.
Which one?
Sabretooth.
Oh, I don't know.
He has a.
That was after this movie, yeah.
He's in the second one, Leif Schreiber. That's not a spoiler, but. Yeah, sorry.
Oh, yeah,
he's,
he would definitely need to be.
Yeah, he's. Yeah. And he is literally just like a walk on cameo in this one, but yeah. Good flick. Love it.
I appreciate Drew Barrymore Roger Jackson. Doing what she did because that was great.
She's so good, and the opening is the best scene of the movie, for sure.
Casey.
Would you agree with that?
What?
The opening is the best part?
It's great.
It's so well done.
It's horrible, but it's great.
Yeah. But the rest of the movie is really good, too. Like, it's just really fun characters. And, Matthew Lillard just steals the...
Deputy Dewey, if I didn't realize that was his name.
Expelled teen.
So they did get expelled.
Yeah. Now we know.
What happened to them?
Yeah. Bored teen.
Bored teen.
Yeah. I don't know which one that one.
One of the ones watching the movie.
All right, guys. Well, thanks for listening to this commentary track for Scream.
I hope it was entertaining for you, informative, maybe.
If it was, we might do Scream 2 and Scream 3 and 4 if this one's good.
Comment down below if you want to see that.
Yeah, I'd love to watch the sequel.
Like it if
guys.
You want, favorite it. I don't know, share it to your friends.
Yeah. Fun flick. I'll be really excited to watch the sequels because I'm assuming neither of you have seen any of that.
No,
so you really won't know who the killer is in Scream 2 or Scream 3 onward.
I'm more excited for that because I've seen.
I've known this
movie. Yeah. So,
for sure, it'll be a fun time. It'll be exciting. So, thanks for listening. Any final thoughts?
This is a weird music for the end credits. I'm
gonna... John, skip.
There are some interesting music choices, but I liked them.
Yeah, for sure. Any other final thoughts, Elijah?
No.
How are we gonna end this?
Good time.
It was good.
Ah!
Oh,
wait.
I guess. R.I.P. Wes Craven.
R.I.P. Wes Craven. Okay. You're the man. You're the best.
Peace. Wes Craven. We love you.
Thanks for listening, guys. Bye-bye. Bye.